Buddhist prayers to remember the dead and the survivors of Sunday's attacks in Sri Lanka. This is one of the holiest Buddhist temples in the country, but the turnout in Kelaniya is small. In these times of heightened tensions, no one is keen to draw too much attention to events that are even remotely religious. Yet, the head monk here tells us it's important for them to hold this small ceremony.
We are always with them. The religion is not a matter. We are human beings. So this attack is not really, I find that, made to a particular religious section. This attack is really aimed at the humanity.
In Colombo, an interfaith organization organized a meeting between ambassadors from various Muslim countries and the Archbishop of the Roman Catholic Church.
Religious sentiments bring people together, not divide them. So we have, unfortunately, some people are trying to instrumentalize it and put it on one religion or the other. That's not correct, because these people who engage in this kind of attacks are not people who believe in a religion. Terrorism has no religion.
The unity presented by leaders of the different religious communities is in contrast to isolated reprisals against the minority Muslim community of Pakistani Ahmadi refugees. Hundreds of them have escaped from Negombo, one of the cities attacked on Sunday.
They're hitting us. Even our landlord is not letting us live here. She is saying, get out of here and go wherever you want to go, but don't live here.
The message of unity and acceptance preached by religious leaders, not heeded by all. Many Sri Lankans are old enough to remember the war that ended only a decade ago. No one wants to return to the past. Religious leaders here tell us it's ever more important now to ensure a united, multi-faith nation. Florence Looi, Aljazeera, Kelaniya, Sri Lanka.